China has once again flexed its muscles against Malaysian claims in the South China Sea. This time, air power was used instead of the typical deployment of Coast Guard vessels or maritime militia. Malaysia has stated that it had summoned China's ambassador after 16 Chinese military aircraft flew over disputed waters off its eastern state of Sarawak. The Chinese PLAAF jets were Ilyushin 276 and Xi'an Y-20 strategic transport planes that can perform several kinds of operations. Fighter jets were scrambled to intercept the planes, and Malaysia's foreign ministry described the Chinese maneuver as a serious threat to national sovereignty. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how China has started aggressively circumventing the exclusive economic zone of Malaysia. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft or ship, and 3 days of premium account. According to RMAF, or Royal Malaysian Air Force, the Air Defense Center in Sarawak spotted the 16 PLA Air Force planes' suspicious flight around 11:53 a.m. The Chinese planes were seen entering the Malaysian Maritime Zone, ZMM, at 333 miles per hour, cluster between 23,000 and 27,000 feet above the high water mark. The Foreign Ministry of Malaysia said on June 1st it would summon China's envoy to explain the intrusion by Air Force planes into its airspace. An official statement read, "The ministry will issue a diplomatic note of protest against the intrusion to the government of the People's Republic of China. The ministry will also summon the ambassador of the People's Republic of China to Malaysia to provide an explanation regarding this breach of the Malaysian airspace and sovereignty by the 16 PLAAF aircraft." Malaysian Air Force said in a statement, "The Air Force planes were flying in tactical formation." After being told to turn back by the Malaysian air traffic control, the combat aircraft failed to respond and continued advancing towards Sarawak River. The RMAF then dispatched Hawk 208 fighter jets from Labuan Air Base's 6th Squadron to intercept those planes, according to media reports. Around 1:33 p.m., RMAF scrambled several jets to intercept the Chinese planes as they infiltrated national airspace to conduct a concrete identification. RMAF Chief General Tan Sri Akbal Abdul Samad was quoted as saying by media, "They were flying over Singapore's FIR, Flight Information Region, a section of Indonesian airspace managed by Singapore, before entering Malaysia Maritime Zone, and continued to pass the Kota Kinabalu FIR to Sarawak coastal areas." He added, "Their flight path changed above a small island called Beting Petinggi Ali, which is on Malaysian soil off the coast of Sarawak." The RMAF stated that the Chinese planes were flying in formation in trail at a distance of 60 nautical miles from each other. The statement added further, "This incident is a serious matter that threatens national sovereignty and aviation safety. The Foreign Ministry has taken note of this through the Defense Ministry." China has rejected Malaysia's criticism about its Air Force's activities, saying that its warplanes had been conducting routine training in accordance with international law. Foreign Ministry spokesman Wang Wenbin said, "This is a routine training activity carried out by the Chinese Air Force in waters south of the Nansha Islands, China's name for the disputed Spratly Islands, and is not targeted at any country. During the training period, the Chinese Air Force strictly abided by international law and did not enter the airspace of other countries, said Wang, adding that China had already communicated with Malaysia on the matter. A statement from the Chinese embassy in Kuala Lumpur downplayed the incident, saying Chinese military aircraft enjoyed the freedom of overflight in the relevant airspace. A spokesman said, during this training, the Chinese military aircraft strictly abided by the relevant international law and did not enter the territorial airspace of any other country. China and Malaysia are friendly neighbors, and China is willing to continue bilateral friendly consultations with Malaysia to jointly maintain regional peace and stability. As per some reports, the Chinese Coast Guard and naval ships entered the Malaysian territorial waters as many as 89 times between 2016 and 2019. Last year, a Chinese survey ship and a Malaysian oil exploration vessel had a month-long standoff within Malaysia's exclusive economic zone. These violations took place in the South China Sea. China claims almost 90% of the South China Sea through its so-called nine-dash-line map. It says that it has indisputable sovereignty over the sea. The wide-reaching demarcation was rejected by an arbitral tribunal at The Hague in July 2016. Vietnam, the Philippines, Malaysia, Brunei, and Taiwan have disputed these claims. The route's significant, as about $5 trillion in trade through shipping passes each year. China is using an old strategy to assert control over almost the entire South China Sea. Viewers may note that in recent years, China has regularly sent Coast Guard and maritime militia vessels into Malaysia's EEZ. This latest event also seems to be intended to test Malaysia's air defense response time and gather electronic intelligence, such as the RMAF's radar signature and response time. The Philippines has been protesting for months over the presence of hundreds of Chinese fishing vessels in an exclusive economic zone, EEZ, which it claims are staffed by Chinese militia. There's not been much impact, and it's unlikely that Malaysian protests will have any different effect. China's aggressive and expansionist maneuvers is putting it at loggerheads with almost all its neighbors, and are creating geopolitical unrest in the Asia-Pacific. Malaysia needs to pull up its socks and prepare for any eventualities.